गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, माइसेल्फ प्रार्थना महापात्र, लेक्चरर ऑफ फैकल्टी ऑफ नर्सिंग फ्रॉम रामा यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द एपिडेमियोलॉजी, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। एट फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द वर्ड एपिडेमियोलॉजी। व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एपिडेमियोलॉजी? एट फर्स्ट एपी, देन डेमोज, देन लोगस। सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ AP? AP means among, then demos, demos means people, and logos means study. So in one sentence we can tell epidemiology is study about the population. So what is the definition of the epidemiology? So study and analysis of the disease in the particular population, regarding the disease in the particular time, is known as epidemiology. What are the concept of the epidemiology? Mainly three concepts are there in the epidemiology. First is disease frequency, second one distribution of the disease, third one is determinants of the disease. So we will discuss one by one. First is disease frequency. Disease frequency means how the disease is going on, from like that the morbidity rate or mortality rate for the certain disease, that is known as the disease frequency. I mean the time of the COVID, can we see that the disease is started from China and it spread from one place to another place, and how much frequency that is spread, that is known as the disease frequency. Next, distribution of the disease, from where it is started one disease and how the spread, that is known as distribution of the disease. Like that from one state to another state or one community to another community, that is known as the distribution of the disease. And then determinants of the disease, what are the causes of the disease, what are the hypotheses of the disease, that is known as the determinants of the disease. Like that for the COVID, what are the reasons, what are the causes, and what are the risk factors, that are comes under the determinants of the disease. Then we will come to the aims of the epidemiology. What are the aims of the epidemiology? According to the IEA, that means International Epidemiological Association, according, there are three main aims are there. First one is distribution and magnitudes of the disease, then to identify the etiological factors, and to provide the essential data. So first one is distribution and magnitude of the disease and health. Second one is etiological factors of the particular disease. Third one is provide the essential data. So what is the distribution and what is the magnitudes, how the disease is going on, and how the disease is distributes, from where disease is started and from where it's gone, and what is the growth of the disease, that we can able to know under the distribution and magnitudes of the disease. Then etiological factor, what are the reasons why the disease is going on, what are the risk factors, that we can able to know through the etiological factors of the disease. And next, the provide the data, essential data. What are the meaning of essential data? Essential data means how much disease is going on, how many people are getting recover, how many people are can't able to recover, that we can able to know through the essential data. We can also able to know through the vital statistics also, we can able to know regarding this. So what are the ultimate aims of the epidemiology? Ultimate aims is, at first we should know about the disease condition. We should have to remove the disease condition priorly, and what are the clinical symptoms of the disease, through this we can able to know how we can prevent the disease, that also we can able to know. Okay, then we will go to the uses of the epidemiology. Use of the epidemiology, at first use is to know about the history of the disease, history of the disease. So from where the started, when it is started, that we can know through the study of the disease condition. That means through the epidemiology we can able to know what are the proper history of the disease. Then the community diagnosis. Community diagnosis means in which community the disease is prone, in which community the disease is getting more, that is, that we can able to know through the community diagnosis. Third one is planning and evaluation. Third one is planning and evaluation. In the planning and evaluation, we can plan regarding the disease, how we can solve the situation, which medicines can we provide the patient and how it will be solved, and we will evaluate. In the pilot group, we will provide the data and we will do the, in the pilot group, we will do the main small group, we will give the medicine and we can able to know what the outcomes are coming. Okay. Next, we will move to the epidemiological triad. Epidemiological triad. In the epidemiological triad, three main factors are there for which the disease is caused. In between, if any one condition is absent, then the disease should not be caused. So first one is, we can make them in the triangle shape. First one is agent, second one is host, third one is environment. So in the agent, what is the meaning of agent? Agent means for which the disease condition is growing up or for which the disease condition is started. It is the main factor for starting one disease. Okay. So in the agent, so much factors are there. First one is biological, second one is nutritional agent, third one is physical, fourth one is chemical, fifth one is mechanical agent. So in the biological agent, what is the meaning of the biological agent? Any type of bacteria, virus, any living organism, if causes the any type of disease, that is known as the biological agent. Like that, any virus, any bacteria or anything else, that is known as the biological agent. Then what is the nutritional cause? If we take any type of a nutrition, if take less, that is also cause any problem. If we take more, that is also cause the problem. In case of protein energy malnutrition, the deficiency of protein, that is known as the protein allergy malnutrition. But in the obesity, we take the more carbohydrates, then it cause, may be cause the, may be the leading factor of the obesity. So the nutritional factors are like that, any deficiency or any overtaking of any type of nutrition, that is comes under the nutritional agent. Next, the chemical agent. What is the chemical agent? In the chemical agent, there are two factors. One is endogenous and one is exogenous. What are the endogenous? Endogenous chemical is what is comes inside of the body, like ketone, urea, that only comes under from the our body only, itself it's coming. Okay. For any deficiency or any overgrowth of this type of chemical, if any problem is happening, that is comes under the chemical agent. And what is the exogenous? The outside, like any gas, any pollution, that is comes under the exogenous chemical agent. Next, the mechanical, any type of any accident through any machinery part, if any harm is happen in the body parts, that is known as the mechanical agent. So next we will move to the host. So what is the host? Host is the human body where the agents come and grow for spread the disease, that is known as the host. In that case, the human body is the host. So in the host also, so many types are there. At first is demographical host. Next, biological host. Third one is socio-economic host and lifestyle. So at first we will come to the demographical host. In the demographical host, what should come? Like age, sex, education, qualification, like that things are come. Okay? Because during the age, so much diseases are comes. In the age of the more than in the geriatric patient, we can able to see the obesity, then many types of the condition we can see. In the sex, the more diseases are there, many more diseases are there where females are only getting affected, males are not getting affected, or sometimes male are getting affected but females are not getting affected. So that is the sex condition. Then education also help to prevent the disease. If we are educated on the certain matter, then we can able to know how to treat the disease condition, how to take the precautions regarding the disease condition. Next, we will come to the biological host. Like that, any genetic factors or anything is happen, that is comes under the biological host. Then socioeconomic status having a great role on the disease and prevention of the disease. That means if in the case of the lower class family, if any problem is happening, they will think ki it will be happen and it will be cure by that only. But in the case of any middle class or upper middle class family, what will they think? At first they will concern with the doctor. Yes. So socioeconomic status also having a great role on disease and prevention of the disease too. Then what is the lifestyle? If the person lifestyle is having great role, first one, the sleeping pattern, then drinking habits. Drinking habits means if the person having alcoholic or not, that also depend for any type of disease causes or risk factor. If the person is alcoholic, then it's cause many type of diseases. So that is the host factor. So first one is demographical host, then biological host, socioeconomic host and lifestyle host. Next we will move to the environment. So what is the environment? Environment is the condition where the disease is growing, that is known as the environment. So first is the physical environment, second one is biological environment, and third is the physiological environment. So in the physical environment, what the things are coming? Physical environment, air, water, sound, noise, pollution, that all the things comes under the physical environment. Second one is biological environment. Biological, any where we are living in nearly any animals are there or not, or any if there is water is consuming, means what will happen? The mosquitoes are growing and it may cause the malaria and dengue. So any insects are not, that is comes under the environment. And next one is physiological. Any customs, any rituals, any educations, all the things comes under the physiological host. So that are the main factors of the environmental situation. Okay, so thank you.